First up tonight, during this pandemic, we've seen that where students learn has a big impact on how well they do, with in-person classes often being more effective than online learning. But COVID cases, of course, have led to a lot of students having to be sent home.
Today, the CDC announced new guidelines with a test-to-stay approach so that children who can test negative will not have to go into quarantine. Experts say this strategy keeps everyone safe while also keeping kids in the classroom.
And in a moment, we'll talk with a local superintendent who has been using the test to stay method. He's going to tell us how that's going. But first, we're going to start with how this is going to work.
Test to stay basically says to school districts, instead of mandatory quarantines for unvaccinated students who are close contacts to someone who tests positive, those students can remain in school if they test negative at least twice in the week following exposure.
Test to stay is an encouraging public health practice to keep our children in school, and CDC is updating our materials to help schools and parents know how to best implement this promising and now proven practice.
She says proven because this has been tested at school districts all across the country, including Grand Island, where the superintendent shared this with us today. In the first 10 days of this testing program, starting December 6th, the district performed 175 total tests. Only one came back positive, so the kids who were close contacts got to remain in class, and they avoided more than 1,000 hours of instructional time that otherwise would have been lost to quarantine.
And the superintendent joins us now, Dr. Brian Graham. Thanks so much for being here. You know, the numbers that you shared with us seem to indicate that this test to stay program has certainly had a positive impact for Grand Island. So we're interested in hearing more about what your experience has been with it and if you think the CDC made the right call today.
Oh, absolutely. This is a game changer for our students here in Grand Island. And the fact that the CDC has endorsed it and said, and they say it's a proven practice, this could be a game changer for all students across the United States. For us here, you hit the nail on the head. You know, over 1,044 hours of maintained continuity of learning, access to mental health supports, food and nutrition, you know, that's fantastic. So being able to offer families another strategy, another option to keep their kids in school is really exciting, and we're very, very happy to see the CDC sees it the same way.
Dr. Graham, since the pandemic began, schools have had to go through so many different changes and different phases of reopening. You had hybrid models, sometimes full remote. I wonder if this test to stay program is the most successful that you've seen thus far in terms of keeping everybody safe, but also keeping them engaged.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I really want to thank the Erie County Department of Health for partnering with us on this pilot study. We're using Buffalo Home Care as personnel to conduct the test before the school day begins. Our nurses, our administrators are doing an outstanding job with contact tracing. You can imagine it's a lot. There's a lot involved here, a lot of logistics. But with that said, the smiles on students' faces, knowing they can stay in school and be with their teachers and their friends and continue learning, there's nothing better than that. So, you know, again, you know, families have options now. And if this test to stay can be grown throughout the country, we really are looking forward to seeing what the New York State Department of Health will do and how they will react to this very good news. There shouldn't be anything that gets in the way of the New York State Department of Health moving this forward for all students across the state.
Getting a little more into the details of this and sort of how it all works. If a student, for example, is named as a close contact in school of a confirmed positive case, what does that mean for that particular student? How is the testing then conducted, and how many days of testing does that student have to go through to remain in the school building?
Yeah, excellent question. So let's say, you know, my son is identified as a close contact and Erie County would call it day zero, or we would call it day zero. So there was an immediate notification to the school that a person that was in close contact to, say, to my son was positive with COVID. So day zero means, you know, my child would have been quarantined the next day for a total of 7 days and not be allowed to attend school. Instead, now my son would be able to come to school a half an hour early, get tested by Buffalo Home Care, and then given the rapid antigen negative result, stay in school for that day. If that is a positive result, then the child is immediately taken home by their parent and they then begin that isolation. So in our district, over 10 days, we've only had one positive case. So that's really, really, important, obviously, to share in this small sample set. But the larger sample set that the CDC reviewed was from Massachusetts and Utah. And there were 67,000 tests given in Massachusetts, and 66,000 students remained in in-person school because of tests to stay. And Utah had very similar numbers. So again, the fact that there's a lot of planning that goes into the logistics around making this happen. Once that planning is set and that schools across the country and across New York State have access to the rapid antigen tests, I think this is a win-win for families.
It's been so great to have this local perspective on all of this. We've been chatting with Dr. Brian Graham, superintendent of Grand Island Schools. Dr. Graham, thanks again for your time tonight. We so appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome. Have a good night.
Yeah, thank you so much. All right, there is also a testing change that is coming to the border with Canada. Starting this Tuesday, Canadians who make short trips here to the United States will once again have to show a negative PCR test to return home.
And this is in response to growing worries over the Omicron variant. Recently, Canadians who made quick trips here to the U.S. for less than 72 hours didn't have to do the negative test. But again, the testing requirement returns Tuesday, which will impact Canadians who plan to come here maybe to shop or maybe go to a Bills or Sabres game.
The testing exception, by the way, was only for Canadians as they were returning home. All Americans going north of the border have had to do that negative PCR test.
So we have talked so far about testing at schools.